Greetings from Heart Care Foundation of India. The topic for today is hospital-acquired anemia. Up till now, we have been talking about hospital-acquired pneumonia, hospital-acquired infections, but the most important now, new thing is hospital-acquired anemia. That means repeated drawing of blood can cause anemia. Now, the study which has come is in a patient with acute myocardial infarction, where we have seen that if you repeatedly draw blood over the next few days, and the patient may end up into a moderate anemia. And this is for every 50 ml of blood drawn, the risk of developing moderate to severe anemia in the hospital rises by 15%. The moderate to severe anemia is common, and it is very important in Indian population where the levels of hemoglobin are already low. What should be done? The answer is very simple. Think before you draw a blood. Is the investigation really necessary? Don't end up with doing unnecessary routine investigations if they are not required. Check if the patient has got an investigation done in the last few weeks. Those investigations may not be required. On the first day when you draw blood, store the serum and see in the next 3-4 days when you are repeating the blood, can the blood, that same test be done from the same serum? In that way, you will not require a new blood to be given. Have a list. Every nurse should know the list. What is the minimum level of blood required for a particular investigation? Say if it is 1 ml, then why withdraw 5 ml of blood? Use a pediatric collection tube so that the blood collected is less. Similarly, use a 2 ml syringe and not a 10 ml syringe. If it is a 10 ml syringe, invariably you will draw 4 ml of blood, even if the requirement is only 2 ml of blood. Then rationalize your routine testing, and that will reduce the per person ml of blood withdrawn during the hospitalization and preventing moderate anemia. Thank you.